It's finally over. The Magnavox Odyssey, the first home video game console, has been discontinued. As you may have guessed, it's 1975, another relatively slow year for video games, despite me saying it was a big year in the last video. While the original Magnavox Odyssey may have been discontinued, two other Odyssey consoles were released, the Odyssey 100 and Odyssey 200. The Odyssey 100, perhaps, could be best described as the first plug-and-play game in a sense. It was the simplest of the other dedicated Odyssey consoles that Magnavox would make. The Odyssey 100 had two games, tennis and hockey. The Odyssey 200, released a little while after the 100, had improved on it in a few ways. In addition to tennis and hockey, it included a game called Smash, a video game version of the racket sport squash. Due to the nature of squash, being played by either two or four people, Smash had to have those options as well. So it did, making it the first home console to feature two and four player options. Magnavox would end up making quite a few more dedicated consoles, but we'll discuss those in the years to come. As if you hadn't heard enough about Pong yet, Atari partnered up with a division of Sears to release a home console version of Pong called Home Pong. Home Pong originally used hundreds of wires inside a rather large wooden box. Al Alcorn, who you should all be familiar with by now, enlisted Atari engineers Bob Brown and Harold Lee to help him create a single chip that would end up being designed by Brown and Lee to replace the wires. At the time, it was the highest performing computer chip used in a for consumer grade product. Nolan Bushnell and then Vice President of Sales at Atari, Gene Lipkin, reached out to many retailers to try and get them to sell Home Pong. But they all declined it, saying it would not interest consumers and that it would be too expensive. They would eventually contact Sears Sporting Goods and their representative Tom Quinn. Quinn offered a deal, but they were left thinking they could find a better deal elsewhere. They showed off Home Pong at a toy fair in New York City, hoping to get people interested, but it didn't work. They did, however, meet Tom Quinn again, and eventually struck a deal with Sears to produce 150,000 Home Pong units for the Christmas season, despite Atari only having capabilities to produce about half that. With the help of a venture capitalist, they got the 150,000 units successfully produced in time for the Christmas season. In 1975, Nolan Bushnell's recently founded company Horror Games released its first and only game, Shark Jaws. Bushnell wanted it to be a licensed game based on Jaws, but Universal Pictures wasn't having that. The gameplay was simple. The player tries to collect fish while avoiding a great white shark. Shark Jaws sold less than 2,000 units. Towards the end of 1975, another video game first took place. Midway Games released Gunfight, known as Western Gun in Europe and Japan, and was the first video game to feature human-on-human combat. Gunfight simulated an old Western gunfight where two men attempt to kill each other. If the player gets hit with a bullet, they fall to the ground and say, "Got me!" Each player has 6 bullets, and the round ends if each player runs out of ammo. The game also featured some obstacles like cactuses and moving stagecoaches. To round out 1975, there was yet another first in the winter of 1975 with the game Pettit 5, released for the Plato Network. Pettit 5 is one of the first dungeon crawl games, with only M199H coming before it, though M199H is a mystery. We know it existed, but very few other details about it are known. In Pettit 5, the player is tasked with guiding a player through a dungeon while killing monsters to collect various treasures. And that takes us to the end of 1975. Aside from Home Pong being released, it was a kinda slow year if you think about it. In 1976, another classic game will be released, a game that a lot of people should know very, very well. If you enjoyed the video or learned anything, leave a like. If you didn't enjoy the video or didn't learn anything, leave a dislike. Follow me on Twitter, @MittenSquad. My name is Paul of Mitten Squad. Have a wonderful day.